The optimum reaction condition to produce a good yield or high yield of ammonia in the laboratory by using 200 into 10 to the power of 5 of pressure. Nearly this amount of pressure will produce a good yield of ammonia, which is nearly equals to 200 atmospheric pressure. And a temperature of 700 degree Kelvin. Okay, that means to produce a good yield in the laboratory, at the time of preparation of ammonia from Haber's process, the optimum pressure and temperatures required are 200 into 10 to the power of 5 pascals of pressure, which is equals to nearly 200 atmospheric pressure and 700 degree Kelvin temperature. Here, during the process, iron oxide is used as catalyst in small quantities. Iron oxide is used as catalyst, and in addition to iron oxide, a little amount of or trace amount of potassium oxide and Al2O3 alumina. What is the name for Al2O3? Alumina is also used in addition to iron oxide as catalyst to promote or to increase rate of attaining equilibrium. So once again, here the two processes simultaneously takes place in Haber's process to yields ammonia from nitrogen gas and hydrogen gas. When these two reacts with each other, there are two steps. One is forward step and one is backward step. Here in forward step, nitrogen gas reacts with hydrogen and yields ammonia, where in the backward step, the same ammonia can dissociates and produces nitrogen and hydrogen gases. The equilibrium exists, or equilibrium rapidly takes place in the presence of potassium oxide and alumina. Hence, we have to use these chemical substances in small quantity in addition to iron oxide as catalyst at 200 into 10 to the power of 5 pascals of pressure, which is nearly equals to 200 atmospheric pressure and 700 degree Kelvin of temperature. Next one, the ammonia is produced from Haber's method by using a diagrammatic representation I would like to exhibit here, which shows how to produce ammonia from Haber's method. So this diagram will helps us to establish an idea preparation of ammonia from Haber's method. So let us identify the diagram once again, which will have some chambers noted here. This is here, where further it is having a small chamber which can shows like this. It is connected to an area where we are going to place, this is the two pipes during the preparation exits into a chamber in which we are going to prepare liquid ammonia. That means finally the prepared liquid ammonia will be collected at this point. Now let us have these two are inlets through which we are going to pass hydrogen gas from one inlet and nitrogen gas from another inlet. These two will enters into this area and slowly they enters into compressor. What is this compressor? The compressor is used to maintain pressure. What is the amount of pressure we have to use? 20 megapascals or 200 into 10 to the power of 5 pascals, whatever, the same. Next, the compressed hydrogen and nitrogen gases slowly enters here and they enters into the area where iron oxide catalyst and potassium oxide and alumina mixture present. So in the presence of this mixture at 700 degree kelvins of temperature, they slowly starts moving here, and now the reaction expected between nitrogen and hydrogen to produce ammonia. The resulting ammonia enters from here and here and here, finally collected in this area. Liquid ammonia will be collected here. But as we mentioned just now, there are two reactions simultaneously expected in Haber's process of ammonia, forward reaction as well as backward reaction. So in forward reaction, nitrogen reacts with ammonia to produce ammonia, reacts with hydrogen gas to produce ammonia. The produced ammonia will be collected in this chamber. Sometimes a little amount of ammonia dissociates into nitrogen and hydrogen gases will be carried like this. Okay, so this is here. Again, they are going to. So these arrows will show us how the nitrogen reacts with hydrogen to produce ammonia, and followed by how the ammonia will again dissociates into hydrogen and nitrogen to produce the same thing. Again, the liquid ammonia, some amount of liquid ammonia can dissociates into hydrogen and nitrogen gases. So the resulting nitrogen hydrogen gases again enters here, and from here again in the presence of iron oxide followed by potassium oxide, alumina, they are also again converted into liquid ammonia. So this is the graphical or diagrammatic representation which helps us to establish how ammonia produced from Haber's process by reacting between nitrogen and hydrogen. So this is the most important question expected from 15th group elements. Preparation of ammonia in large scale quantity from Haber's process. Once again, nitrogen gas reacts with hydrogen gas at 200 into 10 to the power of 5 pascals of pressure and 700 degree Kelvin temperature in the presence of iron oxide as catalyst and potassium oxide and alumina in small quantities to increase rate of attaining equilibrium. So this is how ammonia produced from Haber's method. But in the introductory region or introductory days of Haber's process, instead of iron oxide, potassium oxide, alumina as catalyst and promoters, iron is used as long back for the preparation of ammonia. In the same process, iron was used as catalyst and cobalt as promoter for the preparation of ammonia. So this is preparation of ammonia from Haber's process. Once again, up to now, three different methods studied by us which helps us to establish an idea how to prepare ammonia. The first one, which may be imagined as the natural method, that is ammonia is available in small quantities in air and soil, which resulting from urea. Urea reacts with water to produce ammonium carbonate, which dissociates into ammonia. Followed by, in laboratory, in small scale quantities, we can produce the same ammonia by using ammonium salts. When these ammonium salts reacts with caustic soda and what? Calcium hydroxide, they results as the formation of ammonia in less quantity. And the most important process is Haber's process. So in large scale quantity, the ammonia produced from Haber's process, the method of Haber's process drawn on the board. So this is preparation of ammonia.